quo, please?
Hey, Mark, they like I
don't know. No, I have my shades in the car.
Okay, everyone, I would like to thank you guys all for coming out today for the UTA Hoodie March. NAACP decided to do this because it was an injustice for Trayvon Martin. And what we want to do is we want to start this off with a brief moment of silence. So if everyone could please just take a moment of silence so we can remember Trayvon Martin. Thank you all. The first person that's actually going to be speaking is our political actions chair, David Butler. Could everyone give David a round of applause, please?
Hey.
Thank you, Dante. Thank you, President Robinson. Give it up one more time for him. But I just want to thank everybody that came out here for support, justice with Trayvon Martin. Kid, if you don't know really the details of what happened to him, on February 26, 2012, he was making his way to his father's house, who lives in a gated community, and he had some Skittles, a tea in his hand, on the cell phone with his girlfriend. You know, just typical young teenage behavior, you know, just being young, innocently. While on the other hand, George Zimmerman, who was in his car, doing neighborhood watch, rightfully so, he was pretty much on neighborhood watch. And I want to say this point right quick: we are no way trying to dehumanize and demonize George Zimmerman, because in the end, he's a human being like us all. But in this case, like us all, at times he chose to make a bad decision, and we feel that justice should be served. And also, you know, but particularly what would happen, he pursued Trayvon because he thought he was suspicious. He had on a hoodie. But the sad thing about it is Trayvon was unarmed. And even Jeb Bush, who spoke here this past Saturday, said that what George Zimmerman did, he is not covered under the Stand Your Ground law, the bill he signed. Because in this case, he was the aggressor. And in the end, Trayvon Martin was killed, shot in the chest, and left there missing for 3 days. His parents didn't find out until 3 days later. And that's just the tragedy of it, because a lot of black families in America have to grow up specifically telling their young sons, you know, about the negative stereotypes that plague them, about how you're, you know, considered a thug and a criminal, you know, based off appearance, a threat. And it's just sad that that still is here today. You know, we've come a long way, but we still have a long way to go. And I just want to make a note of that. And also, I'm glad to see, you know, not just black people here, but, you know, the diversity that's amongst this campus that's in support of Trayvon for justice. Because it's not just a black problem. In the end, it's a human problem.
Yeah.
And we got to come together and talk about, you know, racism, discrimination, and the violence that plagues our society to create a better community. So I'm grateful and blessed to see all you here, you know, and God is love.
Fox, and I'm the student body president of UT Arlington. I'm honored to have been asked to participate in this march for Trayvon Martin. UT Arlington is a university that celebrates diversity, and I think it is only fitting for us to come together as a student body, as a university, and as one people to remember this young man's life. And I would like to especially thank the UT Arlington chapter of the NAACP for putting this memorial together. Our friends from TCU and UNT for coming to support us. On behalf of the student body of UT Arlington, I am truly sorry for the loss of Trayvon Martin. This young man's life was taken way too soon. Trayvon will not have the chance to graduate from high school, or attend college, or become a father. And together we mourn for him, and we offer our prayers and support for his family and friends. We all hope that justice will prevail, and I personally pray for the family of Trayvon to somehow find peace in the midst of this tragedy. I hope each of you will keep the memory of Trayvon alive in your hearts. And I hope you will always remember to live your lives to the fullest. Live for those who have been taken from this world way too soon. Live for Trayvon. Thank you.
Amen.
Next, we're going to have President Silk Littlejohn, who is the Arlington president of the Arlington chapter of NAACP. Can we give her a round of applause?
Hello, my young brothers and sisters in the movement.
All right.
Let me tell you something. Today is the beginning of the end of division. We can no longer sit down and be silent.
Yes.
Look to your right, look to your left. Let's see who's going to stand tomorrow for Trayvon.
Yeah.
We are Trayvon.
Yes.
Say it. We are Trayvon. And because of that, we're not going to allow the stand down law in Texas and any other state to prevail. That is no more than a license to kill creatures of our beings that are not acceptable in a society here in America. So that means because I have my hoodie on, am I going to die today, die tomorrow? We've got to come together as a people.
Yes.
I am so proud of all of you.
Yes.
I see all colors.
Yes.
All nations standing here today.
Yeah.
Because we are all Trayvon.
Yes.
Don't let it stop tomorrow.
Yes.
Let the sound of your feet in this march today continue. It is time that we stand up. We are no longer the minority. We are the minority majority. Do you understand?
Yes.
We can no longer, we don't have to ask for what we want.
Yes.
We tell them this is how it's going to be. Do you understand me?
Yes.
But in order to do that, your voices have to be heard.
Yes.
And we have a pledge of allegiance in place that says we are one nation under God.
Amen.
Indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Not. I don't see it. Yes, we are United States of America.
Yes.
But we are one, not one nation. When we can let a child die over a hoodie and Skittles. And a man walk free.
Yes.
And no one's upset about it. But those that look like Trayvon, that are in the suburbs that's wearing hoodies, that goes to a corner store. How many of you today are going to speak out tomorrow? Let me see your hands. How many of you today are going to go to your legislature, to your congressman, to your representative and say enough is enough and stand up against the stand down law?
Yes.
Now listen. This is a serious movement, my people. You can either be on board or get left behind. But remember, when you get left behind, you're going to be. Think about who's going to be the next Trayvon. Mm. It's not a matter of if, but when.
Yes.
You can step across the street right now, and that's your last day.
Yes.
Don't let your last breath be of silence. Speak out for this young man. Speak out for yourself. Speak out for your cousins, your young brothers, your young sisters. Because that affects us all, regardless of the color of our skin.
Yeah.
We're human beings.
Yeah.
We should unite together as one.
Yes.
This right here is what's going on. Because this right here is the same what you're cheering about when Dr. King was assassinated. This campus cheered at the moment of his death. And now look at you all coming together.
Yes.
To stop death, to stop violence.
Yes.
Keep it up, my young brothers and sisters. Keep it up. Power to the people. 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 Power to the people.
Power to the people.
Power to the people.
Power to the people.
Power to the people.
Power to the people.
Power to the people.
Once again, I would like to thank you all for coming out of here today. As you march, I want you to ask yourself, do I look suspicious? It happened to Trayvon. It can happen to you. He was a young brother growing up in cruel society. Dr. Martin Luther King, if he were here today, I feel like he would be proud of us. One, for coming together for a cause.
But he would also be disheartened because of the reason that we came together. He said that he wanted his children to grow up in a world where they would judge by the content of their character and not by the color of their skin.
Amen.
But now it seems as if we are allowing material things to judge us. Whether you blame the Skittles, the iced tea, or the hoodie, a life was taken and it was an injustice. So as you march today, I want you to understand that you are stepping into change. You being here today, you are a part of a movement. A movement saying that we will make our voices heard. And a movement saying that we will get change. We will get change on this campus. Our voices will be heard in Arlington. Our voices will be heard in the DFW. Our voices will be heard in Texas. Our voices will be heard around the world. So as you march today, please remember why you're marching. You're not just marching for Trayvon. You are marching for the people before Trayvon. And you are marching for the people who are going to be after Trayvon. If we don't speak up now. So give yourself a pat on the back because you came and you're making the change right now. With that being said, we are about to make moves. And we are going to march, and we will make our voices heard at this campus. We are going to start off saying justice for Trayvon. Let me hear y'all say it. Justice for Trayvon. Justice for Trayvon. Justice for Trayvon. Justice for Trayvon. I ask that you all who have signs, please get on the outside so you can make your voices heard, so people can see the signs, so people can know that injustice has occurred. So as we all gather together, please, don't be afraid to get next to someone. Because right now we are operating as one unit.
That's right.
One unit who is after change. Look to the person to your left, look to the person to your right and say, I'm here for the same reason that you're here.
I'm here for the same reason that you're here.
And as long as you all understand that, this movement will be successful. So let's go in an orderly fashion. My executive board, along with President from the Grand Prairie chapter of NAACP and President Silk Littlejohn are going to lead the march along with some of our other speakers. Dr. Shelton, he will be with us. And also our speaker from the Arlington LULAC chapter, Jennifer Fox, is going to be marching with us. Please, let's keep it orderly, but let's make our voice heard. And once we get in an orderly formation, we will begin to chant and we will begin to make our voices heard. Please meet me in front of the library.